Lexi. Lex.
Yeah.
How did you sleep? Any better?
Same as always.
Well, I'm going into town if you want to come. You should get out more. Come on, a little bit of retail therapy might help.
No, it's okay. Thanks, though.
Okay. Well, I will see you later.
You feeling any better about things?
I have better days. I'm just tired all the time.
And what about a job? Have you thought about anything you could do? Et voilà. Now that's better, isn't it?
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Pretty good, if I do say so myself. Okay, I have got a run. So, well, now that your nails are looking all glamorous, I was thinking...
No.
Do you want to go to party with me tonight? Oh, come on! Lex, it's just a few people, you know, some food, some drinks, maybe Cards Against Humanity. You love that. Come on! Look, I'll drive, and then if you really are really not enjoying it, I can just bring you home.
Oh, I don't know, I just...
Please, Lexi. Just try it. For me? I just want the old you back. You know, that fun, outgoing Lexi. Mm. I know she's in there somewhere. Please. Please.
Okay.
Okay, so I will pick up at 8 and you'll be dressed and ready, yes? No loungewear. Okay? Mm-hmm. 8 o'clock. I'll see you later.
Hi.
Miss McKenna, I know this has been extremely traumatic for you. Please, in your own time, tell us what you remember from that night.
I remember us all being on the boat, 5 of us. It was early evening. We just opened a bottle of champagne and we all had some.
Were you celebrating?
No, not exactly. It was hot. And we've been playing around in the sun all day. It all went to my head.
The alcohol, you mean?
Yeah. And then it was dark. Vaguely remembered dancing with my dad and my sister.
Your sister, Chloe.
I was dancing, I think. I tripped up. I lost my balance.
Take your time, eh? It's okay.
They were on the side of the deck. I grabbed on them to stop myself falling. I took them into the water with me.
It's all right. It's okay. It wasn't your fault.
Miss McKenna, I appreciate this is extremely difficult for you, but you really are helping us to piece together the events from that night. So then you, all of you, yourself, your father and sister, you all fell into the water. And again, in your own time, tell us what happened from then on.
Thank you. Hey, gorgeous. How you doing? Sorry, did I wake you?
I'm okay. Almost through another day.
Come here. That's not the attitude.
It's not getting any easier. I still can't sleep.
Are you having nightmares? Yeah, you were thrashing around a lot last night. Did you get your nails done?
Yeah, Amy did them. Tried to drag me to a party.
Tried. Well, maybe next time, eh? Hey, I know something that would cheer you up. What's Chinese? Come on, you're always in the mood for a Chinese. Yeah?
Hi.
Hi, Amy. You all right?
I'm good, you?
Yeah, not too bad. Can't complain. Life goes on.
Yeah.
Does she know you're coming?
Oh, no, I don't bother texting her anymore. I know she's more likely to say no.
Yeah, makes sense.
I mean, I hope you don't mind me just turning up. I'd hate to intrude.
Oh, no, no, not at all. I mean, it looks like she's here for the long haul, so it's her house as much as mine.
I suppose it is.
Well, anyway, I'm off out for a prescription, so... She's in the lounge.
Thanks.
Hi.
Not disturbing anything, am I? What's that? Daytime quiz shows? Have you learnt much?
Figs contain dead wasps.
That's disgusting. Where did your nails go? You scratched them all off.
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. They're your nails. You do what you like with them. Just glad I didn't go to the trouble of waxing you. See, look, there it is. There is that winning smile of yours. Lex, listen. Babe, look at me. I've been thinking and I've seen you over the past couple of months and I don't think you're getting any better. And after last night, look, I really think it would be a good idea if you spoke to someone, got some therapy. I've done some research and I found out that the NHS, they offer counseling for people with PTSD. I think that's what you have, Lex. I know it's soldiers that often get it, but your symptoms are the same. I really think you should speak to someone. Right, do you remember Jason? Yeah, the guy who was in the car crash when his friends died? I heard he had counselling and it really helped him, Lexi. I'll even drive you to the sessions. I really think you should consider it. Baby, you need to speak to someone. Please. Look, I'll pass you on the details, okay? Please.
So I'm thinking about seeing a shrink.
Really?
What's made you decide that? Amy suggested it.
I had to wait ages for them to even get back to me about my physio. And then it was 6 months before there was an appointment. They really weren't very good.
Yeah, all they're gonna do is just tell you what you wanna hear, feed you these little white lies that just make you feel better, but... They can't change the past. They can't change what's happened, Lex.
They'll probably just put you on more medication.
Hey, but it's your choice. If you want to go for it, we are right behind you. But in my opinion, the greatest healer is time.
Come in.
Hi.
Lex?
Yeah.
Please take a seat.
You don't like the door being shut. Don't worry, it's quite common. And then I'll just leave it ajar. That way you won't feel like you're being closed in.
That's better, isn't it?
Yeah, thanks.
So, thank you for coming to see me. My name is Francesca, but you can call me Fran. And you are Lex?
Yeah, or Lexi, whichever.
Short for Alexandra?
Yeah. There was a boy in my first year called Alex, so I was Lexi since then.
So now we know each other's names. I'd like you to perhaps tell me a little bit about you. Maybe a bit about your family.
Okay. We moved to the US when I was pretty young. My dad got a job. We were there years. I mean, we grew up there. Long story short, we came back. My mom never really felt at home there, you know? And then she,
Okay. I know it's hard, but it's good to talk.
Mom died about 3 years ago. From a brain tumor, is very sudden. You just think those things happen to other people. It was such a shock.
I'm sorry.
Dad stayed so strong. I don't know how he did it.
Your mum would have been so proud of you two today. I'm proud of you. You're both so strong. And that's what we've got to be now, strong. For each other. Become better people. Because that's what we are. We're good people. We will get through. I swear. It's going to be hard for all of us. But we'll go stronger for it.
He was the most selfless person I've ever known. He always put us first. I wish I could have met him. Shall we take a quick break? Do you fancy a cuppa? How about a biscuit? I bet you're a chocolate bourbon kind of girl. Custard cream. Ooh, my own personal favourite. So we have a bit more time. I'd like to move on to the events of the day, if that's all right. You don't have to go into too much detail. Maybe just a bit about who you were with, where you were, that sort of thing.
We were in South Africa on our first family vacation since Dad remarried.
What was her name?
Vicky. Dad actually wanted to go to the Caribbean. Vicky wanted South Africa, that's why we went there.
And where did you want to go?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe the Caribbean. I didn't mind if I wasn't paying. Vicky insisted that my boyfriend came too.
Your boyfriend?
Yeah. Isaac, we'd been together about 6 months at the time. Dad really liked him.
So five of you then?
One day we chartered a boat, a small cruiser, nothing too fancy. Isaac has a license, so he took us out. It was such a beautiful day. We played around in one of those inflatable boats off the side. Had a few drinks.
Lex. Lex. Look, was it really that bad? Yeah. Well, I'm sure it's going to be difficult to start with. You did have a pretty traumatic event happen to you, so...
I know, I was there. Sorry.
Just... you just gotta stick at it. Don't let the first session put you off. They're only trying to help. Come on, let's go.
For a picnic.
A picnic? On your own?
No, with Amy. She had the day off.
It's a little bit chilly for a picnic, isn't it?
She brought hot chocolate, so it was okay.
This takes the edge off.
Have some wine?
I thought you couldn't have it with your medication.
I stopped taking it.
But didn't the doctor say to carry on for longer?
I did. For 2 months.
Are you going to pour one for me and Isaac?
Yeah, sorry.
There he is.
Drinking wine?
Seems that I am.
Whoa, go easy. You know the effect it can have on you.
Thanks, Vix. It looks delicious.
You're welcome. How was your day?
Oh, yeah, really good, actually. I had a meet with a new client. They weren't sure the deal was going to go through, but, you know, I went in, cranked up the old charm and job done.
Well done. Knew you had it in you.
How was your day, Lex?
She went for a picnic with Amy.
A picnic? In this weather?
That's what I said.
Must be pretty dramatic the way you're drinking that wine.
Time for bed, madam. You're gonna regret that second bottle of wine in the morning. Tomorrow, eh? Yeah. Get some sleep. You're drunk. Night.
So last week we talked a bit about your family.
And later on in the afternoon you started drinking.
Yeah.
What time is that? 5-ish?
Yeah, probably.
And whose idea was it to start drinking?
I don't know. We had a ton of drinks in the icebox, so it was gonna happen at some point.
And would you say that you usually drank a lot?
Well, I wasn't long out of university, so.
I remember those days.
So,
you were all having fun on the boat?
Yeah. Dad likes to have a party.
That you blame yourself. Sometimes things just happen. There's no reason for it. The universe is just a series of random events. It was my fault.
my fault we fell in the water. It's my fault. It's my fault they're dead.
Please don't think like that. You're here. You survived.
Sometimes I wish I didn't.
Okay.
Thanks.
Anytime. Don't give up now. I'm sure you're making progress, even if it doesn't seem like it. Okay.
Amy.
Jesus.
Not quite.
What are you up to?
Oh, nothing much. Just a bit of gardening, had the afternoon off.
Jeez.
How was your picnic the other week?
Picnic?
Yeah, Alex said you went on a picnic last week.
No, I... Oh, sorry, the picnic. Yeah, it was good, thanks.
Where'd you go?
Just somewhere local, a park.
What'd you eat?
Sandwiches, nibbles, you know, picnic things.
What kind of sandwiches?
Look, I'm really sorry. I've got to head off, so I'll catch you later, okay?
Okay. Bye.
Miss McKenna, I'm going to show you a couple of photographs. This is the dinghy the Coast Guard found you clinging to. Do you recognise this dinghy?
Yeah, it's from the boat.
And you and the other people on board were playing in this inflatable during the day. Dinghy came to be in the water at night.
I think Isaac or Vicky threw it in to help.
You know, if you've got health problems, you can talk to me about it, you know. Whatever it is, I've probably had it myself, or at least had experience talking to people about it. Come on, I'm all ears.
It's nothing, I'm fine. It's just a checkup.
For what?
A scan, it's nothing.
All right, well, you know where I am if you need me.
Thanks.
You're not pregnant, are you?
God, no, definitely not.
Good.
There may be another reason why you reach for the alcohol, though. It's common for people who've suffered a traumatic experience,
like you did, for them to try and recreate that experience in order to prove to themselves that they could stay in control. It's a form of catharsis. Now, it's possible that you have reached for the alcohol to try and prove to yourself that you can stay in control. And that maybe there was another element that meant that it wasn't your fault, like you so far believed.
What, so you think there's something more to it?
I'm suggesting there might be another reason why you've started drinking again. I mean, you told me you could handle your drink in the past. You told me that it was a hot day and you were expending plenty of energy, swimming, having fun in the dinghy. It's possible that you were lightheaded, dehydrated, thirsty. You had a couple of glasses of champagne. Now, the bubbles make the blood absorb the alcohol more quickly. I know if it was me, I'd be more than a little lightheaded.
Possibly, but I still never black out like that. Even when I'm really wasted, I remember everything. Even when I don't want to, it's kind of annoying.
Well, it's the first time for everything. Happens to most drinkers eventually, although there is usually a combination of things which make you black out.
There was something in my drink.
You think your drink may have been spiked?
Maybe.
But that is a strong statement. I mean, do you have any reason to think that anyone would try and drug you?
No. Dad would never. Chloe wouldn't, not even as a joke. Isaac would have no need to. We were actually having sex back then, and Vicky.
Would you have any reason to believe that Vicky would?
No.
Okay, well, let's go over it again with that in mind.
Waiting for you.
I'm sorry, I needed a walk.
Well, you could have answered your phone. Wine, Lexi?
No, thanks.
Probably a good idea. You were snoring a bit last night.
Yeah, you had a good old crack at that gym. You celebrate him?
You know that night in South Africa?
You mean?
The night my dad and Chloe were killed.
Yeah.
Can you remind me what happened exactly? I just want to clarify a few things. I know I was drinking a lot and need to remind myself that it was an accident.
Okay. Yeah, we hired the yacht.
Whose idea was that?
I think it was your dad's.
Oh, yeah, he knew I could sail one.
Go on.
Then we sailed out off the coast to the shallow waters and dropped anchor.
Okay. How far out?
Not far. Half a mile. Then we dropped the dinghy, played around in it a bit and Sullen.
So you got in it?
Yeah, I was in the thingy with you at some point.
Okay. When do we start drinking? Half five, six?
Yeah.
And we were drinking what?
Champagne? Oh, no, sparkling wine. Local stuff. It was quite good.
Yeah, Dad poured that, right? Yep. And then?
Then we played a few games, you know, card games and so on.
Who won?
We all won.
Yeah, I mean, we weren't exactly keeping track, so.
And we were all drinking.
Yeah.
Okay, so after the first glass of champagne, who gave me the next one?
I don't know. It's quite a long time ago.
Lex, what's this about, huh?
I'm struggling to come to terms with it and just want the details.
Yeah, but we've told you all of this before. Nothing's changed.
I know. I can't understand some things, like how did we end up in the water?
You tripped. Lexi, we've been over this. You tripped.
You were very drunk.
Yeah, very drunk. But more drunk than I have ever seen you. We were all dancing around, having fun, and you tripped. You grabbed onto your dad and Chloe and tried to use them to save yourself, but just ended up dragging them in with you.
You were there. You saw?
Yeah, well, I was below deck with Vicky.
You just said we were all dancing.
We were?
Yeah, we were. I mean, you know how parties are. People go off in different directions, different rooms, and
music was really loud on the deck.
Yeah, so we went below for a chat.
What were you talking about?
Well, it was about the plans for the next few days.
Oh, yeah, we were going to go up Table Mountain and stuff.
If you were below deck, how did you know that I tripped?
Well, you told the police.
If I don't remember, how did I tell them that?
You suffered a very traumatic experience. And in a lot of trauma cases, you might remember straight after, but then after that, you're going to forget. Probably what happened. You told the police, and now you've forgotten. And you were drinking. Drinking affects the memory. I mean, you can blank it out all you like and we can go over the details again and again if you want, but it's not going to change what happened, and it's just, I mean, it's not going to change the fact that it is your fault. And nothing we can say is ever going to change that. And that's just something that you're going to have to live with the rest of your life. You okay?
Do you care?
Sorry, I was a bit harsh earlier. You know, you gotta be cool to be kind and all that. Hey, so you got drunk. Everyone gets trashed occasionally, especially at your age, and bad shit happens when you drink. And yes, this was very bad shit, but you've got to come to terms with the fact that this was your fault. And nothing we can ever say would change that. Anyway, I've...
What's that? Is that a scar?
Yeah,
How'd you get it? I don't remember it.
Oh, just a
work too. I think it was a cheese board or something.
Place to cut yourself.
Yeah, well, I mean, I was drunk. I don't exactly remember it, so.
Drinking does affect the memory.
Anyway, like I was saying, I've got to head to work. It's this fucking deal with Japan. I know it's so annoying, but just got to go to the office and finalise a few things, so I might be there till the early hours, or I might just stay there. Anyway, take these. I thought maybe help you sleep. You've been having trouble, so. Take them. Been the same since you haven't been the same, and this just kind of happened.
Oh, it just happened. What? You won't fucking touch me, is she? Why? What other lies have you been feeding me?
Lex, please just calm down.
I hate you.
Morning.
What are you still doing here?
I live here.
Not anymore. Get the fuck out of my house.
But it's my house, Lexi. Realistically, I could ask you to move out. I mean, you've been living here for these past few months without paying any rent. But no, I've been good to you. Extremely patient. Paid your way while you've been out of work, cooked for you, cleaned for you. put up with your moods. Acted like a mother to you.
You're sick. My mother could never do that to me.
Oh, sweetie. That relationship died months ago. You didn't really think he was going to stay with you while you were in this state, did you? It was inevitable. We were just waiting for the right moment to tell you.
You didn't just tell me, you showed me.
Well, we thought you'd be asleep.
Asleep? That's your excuse?
A few minutes. I really need to talk to you.
I'm sorry. I'm with a client, and I'm.
Please, just 5 minutes.
No, no, it's fine. I'll wait outside.
Really?
It's fine.
I'm so sorry.
Thank you.
Lex, this is the most.
They
fucking did it. Vicky and Isaac. I'm sure they had something to do with it.
What? The attack.
I've been piecing it all together, and the more I think about it, the more it just fits. And I caught them. I caught them.
Oh my God. Okay. Before you make any assumptions or go around accusing anybody, let's go over the facts. Right. The police. They ruled out anything suspicious, didn't they?
Yeah.
Then you need to be absolutely sure. Let's go through it again.
So, Miss McKenna, and I hate to ask this, but is there any reason you can think of as to why this might not have been an accident?
Not an accident.
Yes, sir. Any reason you believe that maybe somebody in your party wanted to see you, your father and your sister end up in the water?
No, no way.
Okay, so as far as your opinion goes, the events were usual. There was nothing suspicious.
No, I don't think so.
Is there a chance that your drinks might have been spiked?
Why?
You tell us. We don't know the people involved. You'd have a much better idea than we would. Vicky, for example. You said she's your father's second wife.
Yeah.
And what are your feelings towards her? Any hostility between you?
I mean, it's weird. I mean, my mom died, and she had been there my whole life. I mean, I guess I thought it was a little soon for Dad to remarry, but he was happy. It wasn't my place to question that.
get out of my way.
How was counseling?
Looking for these?
Give me those.
Familiar? What's going through your mind, Lexi? You feeling lucky? Probably not a good idea to go into the water. You know, could be anything in there. Crocodiles. Maybe a piranha. It's amazing what you can get off the dark web these days. Oh, and in case you forgot, what with all the wine and drugs, it's your sister's birthday today. Yeah, she would have been 20 if she hadn't. Weird things, birthdays, aren't they? People celebrate as if you've made some massive achievement, when all you've really done is just gone another year surviving. Hardly an achievement, isn't it? Maybe it is. Anyway, I thought I'd pay a little tribute to your sister. So I've put together some scenes from her last birthday. No images, just sound. But I'm sure you won't struggle to put the pictures in. That's the great thing about memories, isn't it? You can replay them over and over and over again. Good luck.
Just water. won't get in here.
Then come out! Come on, tell me what the fuck is going on! Come out, or I'll...
You what? Break up with me?
You sure as hell won't get out of the house.
We've got a pretty good setup in here. Plenty of food.
An ensuite. And of course, your stepmom for entertainment.
So you'll never escape. There are two ways out of this for you. You can either slowly starve and freeze to death. It's only your memories to keep you company. You can take the easy way out. You have a knife. There's an assortment of pills in the kitchen. And we left you a nice bottle of wine as a farewell present. The choice is yours.
Find out soon enough.
after all the fun you've had, you should know the reality isn't what our eyes always see. Don't. How does it feel to lose control of your plan at the last moment? God, that must be frustrating.
Plans?
Please. All I've had from you was lie after lie after lie. This time you're gonna tell me the truth. If you want me to call for help so you don't bleed out on my floor, you're gonna tell me what exactly happened that night. I wanna know all of it.
We hired a yacht. Took it out into the shallow ends off of the coast. Got out in the dinghy, snorkeled. Enjoyed the sun. And then drank a bit on board.
Remember that. Go on.
And then we spiked your drinks. All three of you. And waited until you eventually passed out.
I did trip over. But it was over Chloe, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And then?
We went out deeper into the ocean. To some area known for being infested with great whites. We threw you out to sea. And left you for the sharks.
That's how you cut your hand, isn't it? You got the scar because you were trying to attract them.
Yeah. And we slashed the dinghy and threw it out to make it look like an accident. Like you drunkenly got out in it.
Well, that backfired. It ended up saving my life. And you know, for most of the last year, I've been wishing it hadn't. But, my God, am I happy to be alive. I'm gonna spend my life watching you two spend the rest of yours rotting in prison. Don't you dare.
Wait, I had nothing to do with this.
This is all right.
Lexi, I understand your anger. I know how this might look.
It looks like you're an accomplice to murder.
I have nothing to do with this. This was all on you.
You fucking roped me into this.
You're right, Lydia.
Let him finish.
This happened way before I met you, Lex. I wasn't. I am a gardener. Mowing lawns and cutting trees, nothing glamorous. One of the guys whose lawn I mowed was an old guy. Mr. Randall. One day he was feeling really poorly, so he asked me to go to the pharmacy and pick up his prescription. So I did. Vicky worked behind the counter at the pharmacy. She asked so many questions and she was so flirty. I said she hoped to see me again soon. Next thing I knew, she turns up at Mr. Randall's house. Tells me to get in the car for a chat. That's where it all started. A few weeks later, Mr. Randall was dead. He left me some money in his will.
Fantastic story. What a wonderful imagination.
Oh, you're a fuck. Befriending old, vulnerable people so you can fuck with their education.
Well, they were gonna die soon anyway.
So it was you who laced the drinks.
I'm sorry. It was never meant to go this far. It was never
meant
to.
It's a little bit late for that. Dad had life insurance. With the three of us out of the way, you'd have the money and your house all to yourself.
No, it wasn't about the money.
And what? Then Isaac came along and maybe that wasn't a coincidence either. And you planned a little family holiday together. You were so insistent on South Africa. More sharks, right? I mean, it makes sense.
It's not true. It's not true.
You know what I don't get? You want to kill me, right? I've been in this house with you for a year. What took you so long?
Wait. Let's make this nice and easy, okay? What do you want? What can I do to make all this go away?
I want my dad and my sister back.
Lexi, please.
Okay, there's something you can do. Sign over the deed to the house.
I had my last session today with Fran.
Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So, the house, have you decided what you're doing with it?
No. I don't think I can let go of it.
You're not going to sell it?
No.
Lex, you'd make a mint.
I know, but it was Dad's and Grandpa's, and it meant so much to them, so.
So, have you heard from Isaac or Vicky recently?
No. And I don't think I will for a very long time.
But hey, brighter days ahead. Shall we do a cheers?
Okay. To a fresh start.
To a fresh start.
And more wine.
Always.